what's cracking with it, you feel me? I'm about to sit here and drop my first little motherfucking hood edition of my summary of my weekly news type of shit, you know what I'm saying? I'ma do this shit every week, probably, depending on how this shit go. You know what I'm saying? Any motherfucking ways, I'm finna talk about some of this Stacey Dash shit, this motherfucking snitching ass nigga Takeisha. I'm finna sit here and go over some of this court shit that's cracking this week with this Amber Geyer bitch, this Dallas police officer killing one of our motherfucking kings and shit in his own motherfucking residence. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm about to check out this throwback track, not track, interview of the queen, Nicki motherfucking Minaj. You know what I'm saying? So, first things first, the house nigga. The house nigga Stacey Dash, you know what I'm saying? The motherfucker who wanna be white so bad, but skin tone just won't motherfucking allow it. What's cracking with her? Shit. Just some house nigga shit, you know what I'm saying? What's this, she on her like her fifth marriage or some shit like that? Man, look. This bro got her nigga wake up call. You know what I'm saying? Like, she got her nigga wake up call. Let's check this shit out real quick and see what the fuck this motherfucker got going on, man.
Stacey Dash is accused of battery after an incident in Newport Richey. The Clueless actress since posted bail. According to an incident report, police took Dash into custody after an argument with a male. She's accused of pushing and slapping him. The report says the victim has red scratch marks on his upper left arm from being pushed. Katie Johnston for CBSMiami.com.
Yeah, see, you could already chop that shit up like a motherfucker. You at the crib with your husband, white man at that, you know what I'm saying? And you get into that shit, you put hands on a nigga, and you call the police, you know what I mean? But when the police come through, they see, oh, this is a white man with this, with this nigga, bro, you know what I mean? Who you think going to jail? Exactly. Why that nigga sits at home, posted up, you know what I'm saying? You go to jail. See, that's some classic shit. That's some classic shit. It really is. Because it's like, damn, what's wrong with being a sister? You know what I'm saying? What's wrong with being a sister? Not a damn thing. That's one of the motherfucking best privileges you can have in the world is being a black woman. You feel me, though? Being a black woman. There is no bigger gift than that. You know what I'm saying? But we gonna see how this shit play out for this house nigga, though. You know what I mean? She ain't been endorsed by niggas since I don't know when. But yeah, niggas ain't fucking with no motherfucking Stacey Dash. I'm definitely not doing that shit. That Clueless shit missed me with all that. You know what I'm saying? But, you know what's next, though. You know what's next. I got to get on this nigga Takeisha, cuz. I got to. Now, I don't know. Some niggas might not have the same ethic when it comes to street shit. And we just gonna leave it at street shit. We ain't finna put a bunch of shit on it. We just gonna go street shit, right? Alright, so, nigga, the street shit, from what I'm hearing is, you know, mixed emotions and shit. Like, some niggas is cool with cuz snitching, or some niggas is like, you know, fuck this nigga. Now, the niggas who's cool with this nigga snitching, I've been seeing niggas say shit because they was fucking this bitch. They was kidnapping this nigga. They was stealing money from him. All types of shit. Would you be loyal to them type of motherfuckers? See, that's the wrong question off the rip. It's not would you be loyal to them. You gotta be loyal to the streets. Cause at the end of the day, how many niggas was you stealing money from? How many niggas bitches was you fucking? You know what I'm saying? And just cause a nigga did any of that shit to you, what the fuck does that got to do with the crimes that you was committing? You know what I'm saying? You can't do the time, so you want to sit here and go rat on every motherfucking body. You was a snitch, bitch. You know what I mean? There is no excuses for a motherfucker telling on a motherfucker. Now, I only believe in cooperate with the law if you snitch on the police. You know what I'm saying? If you tell on the police, then it is what it is. But if you out here getting grimy with these niggas, you know what I'm saying? Robbing niggas, recording niggas, robbing motherfuckers and shit like that. And when shit hits the fan, my nigga, it ain't big B's no more. It's lowercase B's, my nigga. And if you telling on motherfuckers, you sending niggas up the motherfucking road, my nigga. Like, you responsible for that shit. Real life. And then, on top of all of that, nigga, I'm hearing that this nigga ain't finna go to witness protection. He still wanna make music. This is a real street call, because artists that you see still fucking with this motherfucker, niggas that you still see going to concerts and shit, this nigga, them is the niggas in the world that you personally, you know what I'm saying, want to stay away from. It's just that simple. You don't want to be around no rat ass niggas like that, man. And then you probably still gonna come out, my nigga, talking this gangster shit. Nah. I just can't. You know what I'm saying? That's me. I can't deal with no shit like that. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know. Do you think that shit was justified? How do you really feel about cuz telling on motherfuckers? You know what I'm saying? Like, there is no excuse. Cause you wasn't worried about none of that shit. You was out here on the streets making this bread. You know what I'm saying? That's your fault you got kidnapped. That's your fault. And as far as Shotty and all them, they got, nigga, what they had coming. You put this poop-put ass nigga on to make some bread, you know what I'm saying? You know, us Cali niggas don't get down like that. Well, I know me, a South Sac nigga, we ain't moving like that. If you ain't throwing bread, my nigga, it is what it is. Because end of the day, nigga, them dollars, my nigga, ain't going to be worth it. When your ass is sitting there, nigga, behind bars, you know what I'm saying? You make $50,000 off one nigga, right? Let's just say you make $50,000 real quick, right? That's all you made. Now, some street niggas, $50,000, you know, we can turn some shit around. But you sit there and got a case like this with a RICO Act, my nigga, $50,000 ain't even gonna get you a decent lawyer, in my opinion, nigga, for the shit that you gotta endure. Y'all niggas had that shit coming. You know what I'm saying? Y'all niggas want to be up there throwing up the bees with this little rainbow Skittle hair little nigga, you know what I'm saying? And this is what you get. This is really what you get. We gonna see how this shit play out, though. But there ain't no crying in baseball, nigga. You can't, nigga, if you can't do the time, nigga, don't do the crime. You feel what I'm saying? Especially if you know deep down in your soul that you finna tell on everybody and they mama. You feel me, though? Nigga, you told on everybody. This nigga told everything but the time. You know what I'm saying? Man, but drop me a comment. Let me know what you think about that whole little G thing and shit like that. You know what I mean? But next, this Amber Geyer bitch, man. The Dallas police. Man, look. This bitch got off work. Went to her apartment complex. Supposedly went to the wrong apartment. Opened up the door and killed our young king while he was on the couch eating ice cream and watching a motherfucking game. You know what I'm saying? And this bitch is sitting here saying shit like, I was scared. I was in fear of my life and X, Y, Z. Bitch, if you were in fear of your motherfucking life, why the fuck did you go into the goddamn place when you seen the door, nigga, ajar? I'm gonna tell you like this. This bitch is on trial right now, you know what I'm saying? I've been watching all of these motherfuckers. It's like day 7 or day 8 today, and today's supposed to be the motherfucking the verdict from the jury today. You know what I'm saying? Today is October motherfucking 1st. It's the first of the month. You know what I'm saying? Type shit. We gonna see what's cracking. If you ain't checked out the trial, go check that shit out, man. That Amber Geyer, long neck, Heineken neck ass bitch. You know what I'm saying? That bitch got that long ass Heineken neck. That shit is nasty, like. Bitch, you can't even... You know how many necklaces that bitch can put on? Is layer them bitches up, cuz? My nigga, you could start choking this bitch and still have a hella neck left. My nigga, like, real nigga talk. When this bitch deep throat, my nigga, that's a real life deep throat. She taking that shit to a whole nother motherfucking meaning. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, I'm about to check out this little clip real quick. You know what I'm saying? Of the prosecutor... cross-examining her, you know what I mean? Let's take a look at this shit. We gotta take a look at this shit. Because this shit is motherfucking ridiculous. None of this shit was adding up from the get-go. You know what I'm saying? Not none of it. At all. But, you know, white people, especially police, they get off with killing niggas like it ain't nothing. So I wouldn't be surprised. And I can't see who the jury is either. I don't know if we got some brothers and sisters over there. I don't know if it's a Klan meeting. You know what I mean? I don't know. But let's check this shit out real quick. Let's get it.
You said, I put the key in and I hear moving around. As the door began to open, I wanted to find the threat. As the door was open fully, that's when you saw the silhouette.
Yes, sir.
So you knew from outside that door, with the protection of that door between you, that there was something inside that was making noise.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, here were your options then. Your options were, at this point, to go in and find the threat, or your option would have been, I'm gonna back off, I'm gonna take a position of cover and concealment, and I'm gonna get some help out here. Those are options, right?
And they are.
Okay. But you chose option A, which was I'm going in to find the threat.
That was the only option that went through my head. I was at home, and I...
Ma'am, will you answer my questions?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, bitch.
You chose to go in and find the threat, even though you were in a position to have taken cover and concealment, right?
No, sir.
Your training, which you've told this jury several times now, that you revert to. You've told them that, right?
Yes, I have.
You rely on that training is what you've said.
Yes, I do.
That's why you pulled the gun when you pulled the gun, right?
Yes, sir.
That's why you keep your right hand empty.
Yes, sir.
That's why you backed your truck in, correct?
Yes, sir.
Because that's what police do, right?
Yes, sir.
But you're telling me at the most critical moment of the entire thing, your training just abandoned you.
No, sir.
No. Because your training says that when you're at this point here, for officer safety, to maximize your safety, do not go inside that apartment.
On a call.
Ma'am, your general orders indicate that you are on duty 24/7.
They do.
And you know that that training is designed for your safety, first and foremost.
Yes, sir.
And that's not only what your orders are, that's how you guys are trained.
Yes, sir.
So for your safety, you should have taken a position of cover and concealment and got help. And instead, you decided to go in.
Yes, I did go in.
You had a police radio on you, didn't you?
I did.
Did it work?
It did.
You live 2 blocks away from police headquarters?
Yes, sir.
You know that when you call out as a police officer, the number one thing for every other police officer is to come and help you if you say that you need help.
Yes, sir.
You know that the response time on this call was about 2 minutes and bodies were at the apartment.
Yes, sir.
Grill this bitch.
So you could have taken a position of cover and concealment. You could have called for help on your radio and you could have had the cavalry there in 2 minutes.
I could have.
You could have had SWAT mobilized.
They could have.
You could have had canine mobilized.
They could have also.
Right. And had you done any one of those things, Mr. Zhang would probably be alive today. Right?
Yes, sir.
See? Now, we gonna see how much... I wonder, see, this has been a long-ass trial and shit like that. And one thing I don't even agree in having jurors and shit like that. That's just not a fair thing. But you really gonna see, like, all right, so I think this is day 7, like I was saying in the beginning of the video. That's a long-ass time to be sitting there. Some of the motherfuckers get restless, tired, and a lot of motherfuckers, jurors, already have their mind made up from the get-go on what it's going to see. You know what I mean? Now, I don't know. I watch every single day of that shit. And I have to say, the prosecution, you know what I'm saying, the state is doing a good job. You know what I mean? Cross-examining this lady right here and getting to the motherfucking facts and asking real motherfucking detailed critical questions to this stupid-ass long-neck Budweiser neck Heineken neck ass. I don't only drink beers when I do it's those Sackies neck ass bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. So hopefully the jury... You know what I mean? They sit here in real life and listen to this bullshit and not pay attention to the crocodile tears that she was shedding and shit like that. But I'm going to have me an updated video up on this shit because like I said, we supposed to find out this bitch is fake today. And hopefully she up in that motherfucking prison, nigga, tonight while we eating dinner. You know what I'm saying? Cut red. But yeah, man, that's sad. That's real sad. Rest in peace to this man. That's just some crazy shit. Like, that's crazy just to be sitting there. Can you imagine laying in your crib after a long day at work, smoking or drinking or just eating some ice cream, watching one of your reality TV shows or watching me on YouTube or watching somebody else or just watching a game and then somebody comes up into your shit and shoots you? Man, and it's the police? Man, you were scared. Look, the last thing I want to hear is the police talking about, nigga, they scared. Nigga, you scared? You the police, nigga, what? That's like one of you queens out there having a husband. You don't want to hear your husband, nigga. Y'all niggas is upstairs sleeping in the room, and you hear something, you wake this nigga up like, hey, I hear something downstairs. This nigga talking about he's scared. Nigga, you scared? Nigga. As soon as this shit is over, nigga, divorce papers is coming your way with your scary ass. You feel what I'm saying? Nigga, scared. You the police, nigga. Like, how you gonna be scared? You in the biggest gang, nigga, in America. You scared? That's crazy to me. That's crazy to me, straight up. But off that shit, and my next topic is Nicki motherfucking Minaj. I've been so impressed, you know what I'm saying, by this beautiful black woman, you know what I'm saying, and her craft. I've been dumbass impressed, you know what I'm saying. I've been sitting here watching, listening to the shit that she's doing. Never paid attention to her the day before. I just started listening to her shit like last month. You know what I'm saying? And I've been impressed. The cadence, just the delivery, the state of mind when you writing your shit. You know what I mean? Like, to sit there and have 3 different flows on one track, that shit is motherfucking insane to me. You know what I'm saying? That shit is crazy. That shit is crazy. So, what I'm about to do, I'm gonna sit here and watch this motherfucking throwback interview. You know what I'm saying? One of the motherfuckers from the get-go, the jump. You know what I'm saying? And see what she talking about. I like to work my way from the from the beginning. You know how y'all got everything from the beginning, how y'all was fans when she first started popping and shit like that. Yeah, I'm in that stage y'all was in years ago. You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm at. I'm just getting in touch with the queen, you know what I'm saying? And I got a long-ass journey to go. So, like I said, I'm about to check out this interview, you know what I mean? And see what she talking about. See what the queen talking about. I just want to get that vibe and that feel. Like I said, I'm working my way up, you know what I mean? And I appreciate y'all for taking that journey with a nigga. But let's check this shit out.
The pony represents your favorite rapper's face. Because you know that's my AKA, sit on your favorite rapper face. And sit on your favorite female rapper face because I don't discriminate.
Damn.
How did you get down with Young Money and Lil Wayne? I mean, Lil Wayne is running the game right now. Voted the best MC by numerous people.
And, you know, the president, yes.
The president. And you know, you're his first lady. How did that happen?
I'm his mistress.
Mistress?
I'm Nikki Lewinsky's mistress.
Whoa.
Okay, pause. Like I said, he's still me on the DVD. He said, I got to have that girl shout it. Ayo, shout it. Y'all want to meet Nikki, shout it. And he met me. Who doesn't take a flight when Weezy F Baby's on the phone? You know what I'm saying? I just got on the flight and met him. We had a long talk about the business. And he's very serious, you know. He said, I want you to be down, and you know. And that's what he did. He started recording, and he's on Playtime Is Over. He's now on Sucker Free. It's really me and him. Like, just about every song is me and him, and he's also hosting the CD. So, I think he, just as well as everybody else, recognizes that there's a drought in the game as far as female rappers. So he's at his height right now. And, you know, it's only right that he introduces a brand new female to the game. So that's really how it went down, I mean. Going down, of course.
How does he help you step your game up?
Because he works so fucking hard. Like, he shows me that no matter how hot you think you are, you can't give up. You know what I'm saying? It's like you have to keep that chokehold on the game because there's always somebody itching and ready to take your spot. And he works like if it's his first day on the job. And I love that about him. So, you know, it always inspires me. Like, damn, if Weezy is doing this, you know, going this hard, I got to step my game up. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm nowhere close to where he is. What else you got for me? I know that ain't all you got, nigga. What? Step your dick up right now.
Oh, okay.
Step your interview game up.
Okay. Here we go.
Look, now he's like, oh, what can I say?
I got one.
What? Surprise me. Do something crazy. Love the wood. Say something crazy.
I mean, you the one on the pony.
Oh, what you trying to say? Because I give good vibes. Like, this is what I fucking do. Like, when I do it, it's done. You know what I'm saying? The pony represents your favorite rapper's face. Because you know that's my AKA, sit on your favorite rapper face. And sit on your favorite female rapper face because I don't discriminate. So if they want to get it poppin', let's go. No, if they want to get it poppin', let's go. Starbucks.
Define Starbucks.
You got to have great box. You know, great box is... Damn, you really...
You told me to step my game up.
Listen, all right, great box, you gotta have a juicy box. That's like a juice box. You gotta have a fat box. Niggas like fat box. I didn't know that until recently when I did the post. I didn't really know. You know what's funny about that picture? When I saw it, I was like, it don't look bad. I told Fendi, I was like, it doesn't look bad, it's wag, I hate it. He's like, what? No, we're putting this shit out ASAP. So I guess niggas like fat box, they like the juice box, they like, you know, warm box, and box. Don't be giving your box away to niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta be selective with who you give your box to. You feel me? Like, if every random nigga in the street can say he got your box, you're not a bad bitch. You need to step your pussy up.
You could say one thing to all dudes out there. What would it be?
I like dudes with confidence. I like dudes that make me laugh. And I like dudes that are nice, you know? know, don't be a prick, don't be mean, just be sweet, and you'd be surprised how much, how far you can get just being a sweetheart. Like, all the guys that I've met so far, like, the niggas that's on the top, they're all sweet. They let me be cocky to them. They let me put them down and be the dominating bitch, you know what I'm saying? Because that's what a man does. A man don't hit females. A man don't yell at females. A real man shuts the fuck up. Right, ladies? If you argue with females, you're not a man. You know, you don't have to show how much testosterone you got. A real man is calm with it. You know what I'm saying? It's cute to be funny. It's cute to get, you know, to have swag. But on a one-on-one, we don't need all of that. Just do your job and step your dick up.
Come on, man.
That's the advice from Nicki Minaj right there. On the pony.
Yes, on the pony.
On the pony.
Hip-hop game, shout out to you guys. You guys are awesome, you guys are great. I love you guys.
Heaven, hiphopgame.com. It's your man Jabari, it's your girl Nicki. We out of here.
Cute.
Interview, you know what I'm saying? I learned a couple of different things, you know what I'm saying, and got a little bit of a different view. I already kind of got how she is, and I don't have a problem with that, you know what I'm saying? A lot of niggas and other females have a problem with women are strong-minded, and why wouldn't you want your black woman to be strong-minded, in my opinion, you know what I'm saying? I don't want no black woman who's gonna fold under pressure or fold, period. I need a strong one. You know what I'm saying? And real niggas don't argue with women. That's a fact. You know what I'm saying? You state your dominance, nigga, from the get-go, nigga, and that don't cause of having to hit nigga nor yell. You know what I'm saying? If your words ain't good enough, my nigga, I don't know what to tell you. But if you gotta sit here and fight, argue, my nigga, yell, scream, put your hands on my nigga, threat nigga, female, use a hoe ass nigga on crib, you know what I'm saying? But hearing how she had met Wayne, how he wanted to, you know what I'm saying? I wonder what songs he had heard. I'm pretty sure maybe y'all know, like maybe I gotta go check out an old Wayne interview. I wonder what songs he heard or was listening to, one of the mixtapes. He was like, man, I gotta meet this woman, you know what I'm saying? I gotta meet her, you know what I'm saying? I wonder what mixtape that was, what songs it was, and shit like that, for him to sit down and be like, yeah, that's the one. Because Wayne, nigga, he was nigga, on top of his shit, like, he was on everything moving, like, he had the game by the motherfucking nuts, nigga, for hella long, like, hella long. Hella long, you know what I'm saying? The game don't really belong to nobody today, you know? It's kind of like everybody got they G thing. So it's hard to just have the game. And he had the game, you know what I'm saying? He had the game. But yeah, that's the motherfucking, my crippin' news right there. I don't know what I'm gonna call that shit. My hood, nigga, ghetto ratchet news, you know what I'm saying, of the motherfucking day, week, whatever the fuck the case may see, you know what I mean? But yeah, drop me a comment, let me know what you think about my ratchet ass shit right about now, you know what I mean? For real, let a nigga know something, you know what I mean? Drop the comments, drop them shits though, don't just watch the video, drop that shit, let a king know something, you feel me? And shout out to y'all, man, real shit, shout out to y'all.